7,000 feet. It is about a three-hour drive from Milan near the French border. Its altitude makes it possible for early season skiing, although even here, snow is scarce this year. Hello, everybody. I'm Bob Viatti. We're in Sestriere for the first women's slalom of the World Cup season. Yesterday, there was a Super G held here, and Marina Kiel of West Germany was the winner. As far as the Americans, well, they waited until the very last moment to come to Europe this year. Usually they get over here about a month ahead of time, and the snow is usually scarce. They have to battle with all the Europeans for time on the hills, and they have to share the gate time and everything else, and it's tough. However, they trained under really excellent conditions at Copper Mountain in Colorado, and I think it's going to help them. As far as the race yesterday is concerned, well, Eva Twardokens was fifth, and Debbie Armstrong was fourth. After the race, I had a chance to talk to Debbie.
I don't believe it, because when I went to the finish, you saw me fall. I had so many troubles, and I'm really surprised at how my time turned out. I just hope it holds.
But you know, it looked like it was real rattly up there.
Yeah, it's hard snow. It was pretty rough. But man, I really feel like I've been training really well, and I was excited for this race. And I wish I skied the upper part a little better. I guess I was a second out up there.
You know, watching you last night at dinner and the day before, you seem real loose and relaxed and very confident. A lot different than last year.
Yeah, I am a lot different than last year. I'm pretty confident because I had a great summer of training. And I was burnt out entering into the season last year. And, you know, I never would admit it was a result of the Olympics. But now that I'm 2 years away from it, I think it was. And I'm a lot looser this year. I'm a year older. And I just have a good summer of training behind me, so it feels good. I'm really happy.
Snow conditions are very weak here and worked out very, very well. Here's how it works. The top 30 finishers after the first run in the slalom will run in reversed order for the second run. In other words, the girl who finished first in the first run will go in 30th or last in the second run. This really kind of means that as she's standing at the top of the mountain all alone, it'll be her race to win or lose. Remember, it's the combined time of the two runs which determine the winner. Okay, now for the highlights of the first run, let's go to Mike Hunter and Vicky Fleckenstein for the call.
Thank you, Beats, and welcome everybody to the first in our series of covering the 1985-86 World Cup campaign. And I'd like to welcome to our ESPN ski team former U.S. Olympic team member Vicky Fleckenstein. Vic, the big change, as Bob was discussing, the, as it's called, the turn 30 format, no reference to your age, but that wasn't around when you were racing for the United States. It's certain to be more exciting for us, the spectators. How about from the racers' viewpoint?
Well, as far as the final racing goes for the racers, it's not really going to change much. They're going to have to go just as all out as they always have in World Cup slaloms, but they will have to change their thinking a little bit for the second run because of the different format.
Of course, it will be the same for everybody.
It will be the same for everyone.
The racer who will be racing the very last in the second run, the leader after the first run, that's Austria's Roswitha Steiner. She leads by 0.3 seconds over Swiss Brigitte Ertli. And in third place at the moment coming into this final run, it's an American, the bronze medalist from the World Championships in Giant Slalom last year, Reno, Nevada's Eva Twardokens. That's got to be a great boost of confidence to that youngster.
Oh, you better believe it. To start out the season with a first run of slalom in third place, that's got to do wonders for her confidence. And also, that carries over into the entire slalom team. I'm sure all the girls are getting excited about the second run.
As a result of the early season snow in the United States, the U.S. ski team got great preseason training, and Bob Viatti talked to Eva Twardokens about that.
I was doing my best to just try to take what I've learned this spring and summer and fall and put it to use and then just go for it. Try not to get distracted.
What do you think about training in the United States and then coming over here right at the last minute? Think that's helped?
I think it's the best thing we've ever done. It was great to be in Copper. Such good skiing, and here we are again in Europe. There's no snow, so I think it was good.
In addition to Eva, there's another American in the top 10 right now. In seventh place, Tamara McKinney, also from the Lake Tahoe area. A great early season start for Tamara.
That is a good start for Tamara. She usually comes on later in the year, February and March, so seventh place in the first run has got to really be encouraging for her.
How about Erica Hess, one of the great all-time ski racers? She stands fifth after the first run. Now, in the old format, she would be starting off this second run, having a nice clean hill out in front of her. But as a result of the new format, she's going to be the 25th racer down the hill. How does that play a factor in her ability to come back and win this race?
Well, I'll tell you, Mike, she's got to forget about those nice clean hills right now because she's going to have a little bit of course deterioration. But then again, she's a veteran and she knows what to do to win this race.
Michela Fagini, the defending World Cup champion, did not quite make the cut for this final run here in the slalom. That's a disappointment to her, but it certainly is no great surprise because slalom is not her strong suit. We will,
as we get set to watch the second and final run in the World Cup season opener, Roswitha Steiner of Austria, the leader after the first run. With a new format, she will run very last. As we get ready to watch, American Beth Mattson coming out of the start in her debut on the European World Cup Tour.
Boy, you gotta know she's pretty excited about this, Mike. It's her first time over here racing in these big races. She's gotta be pretty excited.
Had trouble with her ski pole, lost the grip there for a moment.
Oh, wow, and now her goggles. That kind of thing just really disrupts your rhythm and your concentration, and boy, she seems to be getting it back, though, here. That's good. She's a good competitor, Beth.
She came from the 72nd starting position now as she sheds her hat. 72nd in start position in the first run. She finished 27th in that run. That's an excellent result.
It really is. It's hard to move up that much from starting position like that. Boy, she looks good down here. See those little things that wreck your concentration? A good competitor like her, she just gets her act back together and puts it together down here on the bottom. All right.
So with all those troubles, Beth Mattson posts a combined time of 134.26, and only time shall tell where that will land her. Here it is once again with her problems with those goggles.
Yeah, let's see what happens here. See, originally she knocked them up on her head to get them out of her way. They wear the goggles because their eyes water a lot. And there it just must have been bothering her. She just got rid of the head altogether.
Monika Mayrhofer of Austria, 21-year-old second-year World Cup racer, is on course at the top. Drops off right about here at the fifth gate. It's pretty steep.
Only 2 years on the World Cup. That's a pretty good finish for her first run. She's one of the younger Austrians. Looks really nice here. She's nice and quiet and in good control. She's going a lot faster than people think.
Good back on her skis there.
Yeah, she did. But see how quickly she gets it back? Catches up with her skis.
There's her split time, an excellent split time in comparison to Mattson.
The bottom part of the course here is fun to watch. You can see how close their skis go to the pole, especially right through here in this flush section. Boy, she looks really nice for a young racer.
Austrian Mayrhofer across the finish line in 45.02. will give her a combined time of 132.21, well ahead of Beth Mattson after the two runs combined, and it is the two times that they combined for the final order. Karen Buder is on course, 21-year-old Austrian. 1985, she was the Europa Cup slalom and overall champion.
Yeah, she's a good slalom skier. As you can see here, they have similar styles. You know, they're on the same ski team, and they train year-round running hundreds and hundreds of slalom gates, so they do pick up sort of the same style.
Coming towards the split time. And
right.
Just does post the best split time by 1/100th of a second, Buder.
Boy, there's a lot of competition on that Austrian team. She's even smoother down here, looks a little bit faster. These girls are so smooth on this slalom that it looks like they're not going that fast, but I'll tell you, if you were standing right next to this course, you'd get a good feel for how fast they're going.
So Buder's combined time of 131.95 will put her in the lead. Let's take a closer look at Buder's style down in the bottom section of the course.
Okay, Mike, what's interesting to watch here is how close her feet and her skis go to these slalom gates. I mean, they're literally inches from the gates, and what she's trying to do is straighten out her line. We all know that the shortest line between two points is a straight line, and that's what she's trying to do.
Carving those turns real well.
So that was an excellent run for her.
And her time proves it. 131.95. She's in first place. Beth Mattson, the American, is a very happy young lady, and she's with Bob Biatti.
Beth, that was a pretty wild and woolly run.
It was wild. I had a lot of troubles.
What happened up there?
I started out by actually rushing to my start. I had to hike the course and get right in there, and ended up losing my pole and losing my goggles and had to brush them off and had a little trouble, I'd say.
Pretty hard to get close to the poles when you can't see where you're going.
That's true, especially rapid gates when you're supposed to be close to them, you know.
But you know, that was really a good start for you. Two good runs and really your first big World Cup race over here. And, you know, I think all the people in Aspen are going to be very proud of you.
Oh, well, thanks. I hope so. It's been a good day for me, I think. I'm happy.
Good luck the rest of the season.
Thank you so much.
From event to the 1986 World Cup Tour. And Carolyn Beer is our skier on top, Booter's teammate on the Austrian ski team in her second year on the World Cup Tour. She's 21 years old.
She is young for this the big leagues here in the World Cup circuit, but she seems to be doing well like all the Austrians today, it seems like.
Vicky, she is a small, compact racer. How does that play a factor in the slalom racing?
Well, there's different theories. A lot of people think that being small and really quick is good for slalom, and it looks like it's helping her out a little bit here. She doesn't have a lot of extra weight or a lot of height to carry around and be quick with.
Her split time was just slightly behind that of Booters. Has to make up a little bit of time down at the bottom. Was harsh on her edges there, it looked like.
Yeah, she got low on and wide on that one gate, and it's what we talked about before. You don't want to swing far from each gate. You've got to have each turn be right next to the gate.
Her time across the finish line in combined time, 132.03, means that Karen Booter hangs on to the lead, at least momentarily, by a slim margin.
She's probably happy with that run.
Renny Schneider is going to be our next competitor, and she is a top slalom racer.
She's an excellent giant slalom racer, really. She's had some excellent results in giant slalom last year. She won a couple races and was second. But let's see what she can do in slalom. She has a really aggressive style. She skis a little bit like a guy, like the men on the Swiss team. She has her arms out in front of her, and she sort of boxes the breakaway gates right out of her way. This is really steep here, and she's quick and strong through there.
She won the slalom earlier this year in the World Series held right here at Sestriere.
That's a good way to start the season. She's probably looking for another one today.
That's kind of a warm-up, though, to this.
Yeah, this is the real big time right here. Wow, she looks great there, really cutting off the gates right close to her boots. I don't know, though, she's a little rough. Not quite as precise as the couple Austrian girls we watched before her.
But a good time down at the finish. 131.25 will put her into first place by 0.7 seconds as we look at her again.
Okay, let's see here the difference between her and the other girls. She's just not quite as quick. See, she's got her rhythm is a little bit off, and she looks a little stiff. She might not be quite as agile as the other girls.
Can't be too harsh, can you?
Not in this event, Mike. She's got to be quick and very subtle on her skis.
And she is quick enough to take over the lead as Monica Hess gets ready to try and top the time posted by Renny Schneider. Monica Hess, the younger cousin of Erica Hess.
Monica's had some good results, too. She was 11th in the Olympics, which is a pretty good result. See how powerful they are out of the starts. Those girls are in such top shape from head to toe. I mean, their shoulders and arms and everything are really strong.
She likes this hill, too. One of her best results ever was posted on this hill, a third place in 1984.
And they remember that, Mike. From year to year, you have certain favorite hills, and if you have a good result in an area, you never forget it. Looks like she's really psyched for this run. Not a bit of concentration lapse or anything. She's got good rhythm.
Letting her momentum carry her through the flats now.
It's a little bit flatter down here, but you can see they're still carrying a fair amount of speed.
45.46 will not be good enough to take over the lead. 131.63 her combined time. So Renny Schneider hangs on to the lead by 0.4 seconds. As we go to Camilla Nilsson of Sweden, just 18 years old. Her brother also a great World Cup racer for the men.
Yeah, he's a great slalom racer. She's sort of alone up here. You know, she's the only Swedish girl. She doesn't really have a team up there up at the start with her. I'm sure they're down at the finish cheering her on. But she's holding up the score for the Swedes today.
That's a reminiscent style she's using, huh?
It is, Mike. It's a little bit like famous Ingemar Stenmark. I'm sure a lot of the viewers are familiar with him. He was Swedish. Great men's skier.
Her split time a little bit off the pace. She's really going to have to pick it up down here.
You never know what she might be doing. She might be being a little conservative on this run just to get a sound result.
Ooh, that was a quick set of gates in there.
Yeah, she's making up time down here. You can see that.
Wow, an excellent second run for Nilsson. 44.76 will put her in the lead, 130.76. Let's watch her again in this bottom section where she definitely picked up a lot of time.
She really did. I think she was a little surprised with her result there. As you can see from the side here, her stance is really strong.
Jean Pallon of France, ready to go for her second and final run. The leader right now is Camilla Nilsson of Sweden.
Well, you hit it on the head, Mike, when you said one of the greats. She's been around a long time, Perrine. 8 years on the World Cup, and she knows what she's doing in this event. She's excellent on steeps, and it looks like she is again today. She's always done well because she's got a really compact stance. Whoops, right there, she got a little bit back on her skis, but she's right again back into the course. I really like to watch Perrine Pallon. She's one of the all-time great slalom skiers.
Youngsters can certainly pick up some pointers from watching her French technique. Very smooth and quiet on the snow. In fact, they call her the cat.
Yep. She doesn't look quite as hot as I've seen her, though. It's too bad. This might not be her day.
Her time of 45.6 will put her a bit behind the leaders. Actually, 0.7 seconds behind first place Camilla Nilsson, so it was not a good second run for her.
No, I wonder why. She might be getting a little bit of a slow start for the season.
She seems to come up off the snow.
Yeah, that's a bad sign. A lot of times when a skier does that, they're just a little stiff in their legs. It's a bad sign.
Maria Rosa Quario, a great young lady, 24-year-old Italian, now in her 8th year on the World Cup.
See those gloves?
Yeah.
They use those to knock the poles right out of their way so they don't hit them with their knees or with their shins.
But they do drive right over those hinged gates. They have a hinge right at the snow level.
She's in front of the home crowd. You can hear the crowd behind her. These Italians love to see their fellow Italians do well.
Not only that, her most recent victory as a World Cup racer, 1984, she won it right here on this hill.
So she's got to be pretty excited. Looking a little rough, but you never know. You know, sometimes when they look rough, it's just because they're going so fast.
The split time indicates she was slow up top, and now she has a problem.
Wow, it just happened so fast. You never know. Now, I think we might get a replay on that, and we'll try to see what happened to her there. Okay, here she comes. She's in good control here, no problem. Wow. Okay, could have been just a caught edge, and one ski went on one side of the gate, and the other ski went on the other.
So Nilsson hangs on to the lead as we look at Maria Eplebeck. Added Beck to her name last year, having married a member of the men's team, Florian Beck.
You can see a little bit different style for this German. She doesn't ski like the Austrians or the Italians. She skis very, very erect with her knees tight close together.
She's knocking down every gate.
Every single gate.
Whoa. Oh, and now she misses a gate. Getting a little too close to those gates, unable to negotiate all the turns. And Eple is out of this one.
Here's our favorite.
That makes room for Tamara McKinney, the 23-year-old 1983 World Cup champion.
Tamara's got to be ready for this one. She had a good first run, and that's got to jazz her up for this second run.
Oh, she's bouncing around up top. That cost her a little bit of time, didn't it, Vicki?
Well, a little bit, but, you know, Tamara's funny. She doesn't always do great on the steeps. Her thing is the more gentler slopes because she's very quick on her feet and so subtle.
I think she's going to be happy to finish this one, having last year fallen in 5 of her first 6 races.
Okay.
Into the bottom section.
This is where she's usually good.
Very smooth there.
That was good for Tamara.
Her time 46.22 gives her a combined 131.72, a little bit behind the leaders.
I hope that result holds for her.
This is McKinney again in the top section of the course.
Watch how she gets her skis on edge and jumps from one edge to the other. See that? She just got a little off balance, but a weaker skier, if that had happened to them, they'd be out of the course.
And down at the bottom?
Yeah, this is where Tamara's good. This is her thing. She's just light on her feet. It's almost like she's on her tiptoes. She just goes from gate to gate. It doesn't phase her upper body at all.
No snow kicks up from her edges, indicating she's not skidding at all. Very flat ski. Paoletta Magoni is in the starting gate. She having just added another suffix to her name, Sforza, having gotten married over the summer. 21-year-old Italian, 1984 Olympic slalom gold medalist.
Boy, it's nice to come out of a starting gate with a gold medal in the back of your mind. Must give her a lot of confidence.
I'll bet it does. She was sixth after the first run. Right now trying to catch the leader, Nielsen, who clocked the combined time. Whoa, a little bit of trouble there.
That's a lot of time lost right there. Just that one little skid in one gate can cost a racer a race. These racers at this level make every turn as precise and as exact as they possibly can. They train year-round, literally year-round, running hundreds of slalom gates. And by the time they're in the race course, they're just going all out.
Good quick run in the bottom section. Magoni across the finish line really made up a lot of time in the bottom. Her combined time, 130.91, will put her into second. Some racers in the world this morning, can they maintain that title this afternoon? These are the best four from this morning, running in reverse order. Erica Hess was fourth after that first run. She's out onto the course now, trying to win this one, the two-time World Cup champion.
This is a little different for her, Mike. See, the course is a little bit more rough than she's used to. She's the 25th racer to come down now.
Good, smooth, compact style. She is kicking up a lot of snow, though, there.
Yeah. She looks all right. I'll tell you, Erica can't rest back on her heels, though, because she's got a lot of young Swiss coming up after her, so I think this race is very important to her to get a good result.
She is really letting it out down here.
Boy, she's so quiet and so smooth and steady. Her upper body barely moves.
This technique carries her to four World Cup slalom titles over the years. Across the finish line, great time. 44.99 is going to give her a combined time, 130.22. That will put her into first place by a half second.
Here's what you can see where all her training has helped her to keep nice and disciplined. Her arms aren't flailing all over the place. She's nice and quiet. From ski to ski. Really nice skier to watch. And here she's doing the same thing that we looked at earlier. She's trying to straighten out her line, go as close to that gate as she possibly can. Just knock it right over out of her way.
Yet stable all the time, quiet upper body. Great run by Erica Hess. That makes it more difficult for the American Eva Twardokens. A lot of pressure. The 20-year-old from Reno, Nevada, who was the best in training at Copper Mountain for the Americans earlier in the fall.
Boy, I'd like to see a great run for Eva here. I know she wants it. She'd be satisfied with just about anything in the top five. Let's see what she can do.
Oh, caught an arm.
That's funny. That didn't hurt her at all, though. She was back on the course right away. Boy, she's a really good American star. She's young. She's really picking up on the rules of the game and getting in good results already.
And slalom has not been her strong discipline.
No, she's really a giant slalom skier, but it's turning over in her slalom also.
It's 45.21. Here she comes across the finish line. 45.73 will not be good enough to take over the lead.
I'll tell you, that was a great run for Eva, though, that she's still going to be up there. I'm sure she's happy with that. You know, she did have a lot of pressure on her. This is the first race of the season, third place after the first run. I think she did well.
She winds up at the moment in second place with a couple of racers still to come. Brigitte Ertley, 23-year-old Swiss, out on the course.
Boy, they don't have much space between the start and the first gate. They really got to get right into it. Especially up here on the steep. That's not easy skiing right there. This is one of the girls that Erica Hess has to worry about. Personally, I think this girl is going to be in contention for the overall World Cup. She's an excellent downhill skier, and she's good in giant slalom, and today she's showing how good she can be in slalom.
She was the runner-up for the cup last year and won the combined, meaning that she does race well in all disciplines. Big gal.
She is tall, but she's very strong.
That'll certainly help her down here in the flatter section of the course. And she pushes her way across the finish line. 45.58 will give her a combined time, 130.32. That will slide her into second place behind Erica Hess.
She looks a little tired there. I can tell you that those slalom runs don't, as easy as they look, they take a lot out of your legs. They're really tiring.
One lady left on the hill. That is the leader from this morning's first run. A great day for the 22-year-old Austrian.
Boy, is she happy.
So we have a good training last week in Saalbach Hinterklemm. We have a training also on the man-made snow. And so it was pretty good. I'm feeling well.
Oh, that's terrific going. And you're off to a great start.
Pardon?
You're off to a great start. You're off to a great start.
Ah, sure, yeah. Good start. Yeah, sure. I'm happy.
Congratulations to you.
Thank you.
Well, that just about wraps things up here in Sestriere, Italy, for Eva Twardokens. Really a good finish for her when you think that it's her best World Cup finish ever in slalom. And what a way to start the season. Also, the entire U.S. team, I think, looks in very good shape, and they're going to get better and better and better. Tamara McKinney, maybe not quite the result that she had in mind. She was pretty sloppy in that second run. And she said after her run, I just didn't really have my coordination today. Well, believe me, she has a lot of coordination, and she'll have much, much better results throughout the season. And we hope to be showing you many of those. Next week, we'll be somewhere in Europe bringing you World Cup skiing. We aren't exactly sure yet. We're waiting for the officials to tell us where. Okay, the final results. Roswitha Steiner of Austria, first. Erika Hess of Switzerland in second place. Bridget Oertli of Switzerland, third. And Eva Twardokens of the United States in fourth place. Floor.